I love democracy. I love the Republic.
The main thing is to protect these characters, make sure that they still continue to live in the way that you created them, and that the universe of Star Wars continues to grow.
So one of my favorite subs, Parabellum, basically turned me on to Denim Nerd's rebuttal of WDW Pro's ridiculous rumor that they were not going to go and use Luke Skywalker anymore, that he was a cobwebby character, and they were moving on from him at Lucasfilm. And Denim Nerd started to actually feel like it was real. So he reached out to his own Lucasfilm contacts, and absolutely they rebutted this rumor. You know, when you think about Star Wars, the first character you think of is Luke. And because that is who Star Wars is about. It's about Anakin Skywalker and his son Luke, and then Han, and then Leia. Okay. That's what it's about, right? And Luke being the focal point of the original trilogy, he sets the stage for the next step. And it's his journey. And it's like, why would, first off, you got to understand the person who spread this bullshit is getting his information from Kathy Kennedy's corner, not from actual people who care about the franchise. Okay, these are people who wanted to go in and use Star Wars as a political bully pulpit and beat people over the head with cultural Marxism and woke garbage, okay, to the point where Mark Hamill, who is not Luke Skywalker, I mean, he plays Luke Skywalker, but let me remind you guys, Mark is not a strong person, okay? He very rarely will take a contrary stand to what he feels is popular in Hollywood, which is too bad. But let's talk a little bit. The character that he played that made that was a household name, and it still is a household name. This is what Star Wars is about. It's about Luke Skywalker's journey in the original trilogy. And to actually believe that Lucasfilm would cut out the heart and soul of the franchise, calling cobwebby, is bullshit. But if you look at the last 7 or 8 years, 6 or 10 years of Lucasfilm's attitude towards the original trilogy characters, you'll see that they did everything they could, Kathy Kennedy's people, to drive the cobwebby old white men, Han and Luke, into the ground. Okay. To the point where you even have their sycophants calling Anakin Skywalker an incel. Okay. But look at what they did to Luke. And this, and then put two and two together, and you'll realize where WDW Pro gets his information. Now, he's walked it back and said, well, there's going to be cameos. You know, okay. That's called walking it back. Okay. That's because he's getting his information from people who enjoyed humiliating Mark Hamill every second of filming The Last Jedi, okay? And it's sickening when you think about it, how far they got.
Mm-hmm.
That was outrageous. That was intentionally hurtful to Mark. The man cried on the set because he knew what they were doing. And I'll tell you something else. This whole rumor isn't just an attack on the character. It's an attack on the fans who love Luke, who love Star Wars, and it's another way for them to burn it all down. And here's the person who is telling WDW Pro shit out of school. Okay, here he is right here. This is the person who's spreading all these rumors about Luke being cobwebby and then not using him anymore. And then Den of Nerds comes out and said, well, my contacts call bullshit on it. And we're going to see Luke everywhere to the point where he might even have his own show. Okay, which would be fine by me. I'd watch the hell out of that. This tells me that the reeing at Lucasfilm is at full blast even now, as the time of this horrible woman's era is coming to a close. Okay. Did I even believe that Luke was cobwebby? No, I don't believe that. I don't believe that that was ever said in any meeting. I believe Pablo thinks that, which is why he told Pro that. Okay?
The Force will be with you. Always.
May the Force be with you.
You are unwise to lower your defenses.
I mean, think about Star Wars without him. It's not Star Wars. It's Andor. It's a boring, generic, cheaply made sci-fi show that no one wants to watch. And no one did watch it, okay? Luke's path of discovery just began at the end of Return of the Jedi, okay? He is the only out there Jedi. A lot of them, you know, went into hiding and would eventually come out to help him, I would think. But he is the only Jedi known in the galaxy then. And he has a long journey ahead of him in rebuilding the new Jedi Order. The whole thing, like Pro puking it out about Grogu going to Mando because they wanted to get rid of Luke. No, that's not why. It sold merchandise. Okay, that's why. It's a business decision. Okay, and you know, look, every time this guy shows up and says something, grain of salt, please. Okay, grain of salt, please. Because this is the biggest character in the franchise. And they can't just dump him over the side because Pablo Hidalgo and the Flying Monkeys hate him. I mean, hey, Jennifer Heddle screamed how much she hated Luke Skywalker. Okay. But she hates boys, so, you know, even though she's married to one. But Dave Filoni basically has said that they're going to be using Luke a lot. In fact, today basically said, he's quoted in Star Wars Direct, as Grand Admiral Thrawn being the big baddie, okay? And which basically replaces Snoke and whoever the hell that clone was of Palpatine was. I mean, this is, they're basically replacing the sequel trilogy right now in front of us. Because he basically said, Grand Admiral Thrawn is the big baddie of the New Republic era. Everybody's looking around going, what? Okay, think about it. All right, think about it. You need Luke Skywalker in this heavily, his sister, his brother-in-law, and the rest of the original trilogy cast to round it out. Okay, so the idea that they're just going to be cameos is stupid too. All right, now I want to address one more thing. Shamook apparently is not at Lucasfilm anymore, but I'm going to put Den of Nerds video in the description here so you guys can see it and watch it and judge it for yourself. What I think they did was they put that Shamook was on contract, and once the animators and CGI guys at ILM understood the technology and he taught them it, he was then able to go on to a different job. So he's basically a contract worker there. He wasn't a what I would call a permanent hire. So I'm freaking out about Shamook not being there. It's like, just hold on, okay? And of course, people make up shit when they hear that. Oh, he didn't get along with Kennedy. Do you know Shamook? Did he say that? Or are you just extrapolating that because you're an emotional asshole? Okay? Questions that people need to be asked. But as far as this goes, it's, I think, full on for a lot of Luke Skywalker coming in the future and a lot of the other OT heroes as well. And when I heard Pro say that Kathleen Kennedy or whoever said that Luke was a cobwebby character and that they were going to move on from him, I'm like, she didn't say that. Pablo said that. Pablo said that to get a rise out of you because he knew you would do it. You would you would puke that out there. Now, I could go into why people like Pablo and Matt Martin hate Luke Skywalker. Maybe I'll do a video on it because it has something to do with their emotional issues with, I think, their fathers. You know, and maybe they spent way too much time in lockers after gym class. I don't know. Anyway, I wanted to put this out there. Watching the Black Pill Blobs get defeated soundly and humiliated is, look, it's Schadenfreude, all right? I shouldn't want to see that, but the trouble that this guy has caused is disgusting, in my opinion. And the fact that other channels allow him to come on, it's going to end up hurting them too. Anyway, this is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.
I thought they smelled bad on the outside.